The warfighter needs communications. They need data quickly in parts of the world that don't have cell phone towers and where communication is being jammed. Being able to meet their needs in a low-cost manner is really at the heart of what the DaHGR antenna is intended to do.
The Deployable High Gain Reflectarray, or DaHGR, is a deployable antenna that can be used for communications, various imaging type missions that would typically be done with a parabolic type of antenna. Instead, ours is a deployable membrane based antenna. We deliver much larger aperture for a given volume and mass, and we do that at lower cost to support the Air Force mission needs. The Air Force SBIR program has been instrumental in our growth and health of our company. We started with 3 people and have grown now to close to 30 people. And the Air Force SBIR program has been the foundation for that growth. We received the Tibbetts Award for our success in taking ideas and developing them through the Air Force SBIR program and bringing them to fruition all the way to a successful demonstration and commercialization.
The Air Force SBIR program is important for the Air Force Research Lab. We rely heavily on small businesses to execute a lot of our important new research, and we use the Air Force SBIR program to fund a lot of these small businesses. When we put out the call for this particular Air Force SBIR topic, MMA was one of the companies that happened to propose, and through that process of giving them a phase one and then a phase two, we were able to infuse some of our in-house high-strain composites technologies into their approach, and it was really the partnership between AFRL and MMA that made the DaHGR antenna possible. The need that this DaHGR antenna is addressing is the need for high bandwidth communications between our warfighters. And traditionally that's been done by large satellites, geosynchronous satellites, and they're high in cost, take a long time to acquire and launch. So the DaHGR antenna is providing a much smaller antenna that can be packaged into a much smaller volume so that we can start augmenting these heritage approaches for communications between our warfighters. DaHGR does not have a phase three contract that I'm aware of, but what we do have is a partnership with another government organization who has taken the technology and is planning to fly it here in 2018. So In some sense, we've leapfrogged the phase three process and gone directly to spaceflight through this other government organization. It's a really exciting opportunity. The DaHGR antenna has been able to use the commercialization readiness program, and we've relied heavily on their funding and their support. It takes a lot of money to put satellite hardware in space, and especially the first demonstrations of those hardware components. So we really rely heavily on the CRP program to get us past the phase two and to infuse more money into these technologies so that they can be demonstrated in space. There's no question that without the commercialization readiness program that the DaHGR antenna would not have become a reality.
We're excited to be part of the Air Force SBIR program and enabling future capabilities that will really keep us at the forefront of the mission needs and the support of the warfighter.